میں انتہائی ادب سے بلا تاخیر ادب سے ملتمس ہوں برمنگم سے آئے ہوئے ہمارے مہمان عزت مآب حضرت علامہ مولانا منور عتیق صاحب سے کہ وہ تشریف لائیں اور اپنے بھرپور انداز سے اپنے خطاب سے ہم سب کو مستفید فرمائیں. مولانا محمد منور عتیق صاحب نعرہ تکبیر. میں نے آپ سے پہلے کہا اس محفل کی شان اس محفل کی آن اس محفل کی جان قبلہ شاہ صاحب جلوہ گر ہو چکے ہیں. اب محبتوں میں اب جذبات میں کبھی نہیں آنی چاہیے. محبت سے بولیے نعرہ تکبیر. مصطفیٰ کے دیوانے دونوں ہاتھوں کو بلند کر کے بولو نعرہ رسالت
الذي جعل الصدق على لسان الصديق وفرق بين الحق والباطل بعمر وألبس لباس الحياء والتقوى عثمان ورفع منار الإسلام بعلي وصلى الله على سيدنا وسيدهم ومولانا ومولاهم محمد معدن الجود والكرم وعلى آله وأصحابه وحزبه ومن تبعهم ونصرهم إلى يوم الدين أما بعد والذي جاء بالصدق وصدق به صدق الله مولانا العظيم. With love and affection, wholeheartedness, recite درود و سلام on our beloved Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا رحمة للعالمين. I am very humbled to be present among our noble ulama of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah in the front line, and foremost of them the light of Ahlus Sunnat wa Jama'at, the lantern of Ahlus Sunnat wa Jama'at, the heat of love for Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. حضور مناظر اسلام حضرت علامہ پیر سید محمد عرفان مشہدی صاحب. In this day and age, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him to us, the Ahlus Sunnah, as a gift from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And among the many other ulama-i kiram and Sunni Jamiyat Awam, all those listening, my dear brothers and elders, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Unfortunately, we are living, in a time which is full of confusion, full of doubt, full of conspiracy, in an age of fitna, in an age of trouble, where people are attacking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where people are attacking the noble essence of Rasulullah, and when people are accusing the beloved companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How sad of a time are we living in? How sad of a time that we are dwelling in, when the uluhiyya, the godness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is being questioned. When the greatness of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is being questioned. When the greatness of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is being questioned. You might ask, this has been happening all the time. You might ask, why do I believe this time is one of the most unfortunate times? You might say, this has been happening for all the times. The Christians, the Jews, and non-Muslims have always been saying things contrary to Islam and to dishearten Muslims. But my dear brothers, I am not talking about Allah coming attack under attack by non-Muslims. I am not talking about Rasulullah coming attack under attack by non-Muslims. I am not talking about the Sahaba of Rasulullah coming under attack by non-Muslims. I am talking about a time in which people are wearing the clothes of Islam and they are attacking the taqdis of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am talking about a time when people have beards and are wearing turbans and consider themselves as the great ulama of Quran and Hadith, and they are attacking the honor of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I am talking about those people who consider themselves as the bearers of the Ahlul Sunnah, people of the Quran and the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yet they are attacking the principles of Islam and foremost the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Unfortunately, Islam is being attacked by people from within. But these are people who are dressed in the clothes of Islam. This is the day we are living in. Somebody is saying today that it is possible for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to lie. Everybody say, Astaghfirullah. People say, this was a fatwa given by some Deobandi ulama in India. This has got nothing to do with us in England. But my dear brothers, the debate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can or can't lie has now entered the English language and is here in our homes in the UK. It is no longer a debate of India and Pakistan. This debate has now entered the United Kingdom. And there are shuyukh who consider them as great scholars of Islam. They are validating. They are accepting the position that if somebody says that Allah can lie, he's still a Muslim. This is not a debate of India and Pakistan anymore. This is a debate that has entered our quarters in the UK. Our young people on the internet, they are made to believe that if somebody says Allah can lie but doesn't lie, Allah can lie but doesn't lie, he is made to believe that that person is still a Muslim who says this. Say Astaghfirullah. None of the Muslims have ever believed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the power to lie. If you say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the power to lie, then how do you know the Quran is the true book of Allah? How do you know Rasulullah is the true messenger? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's greatness has come in under attack by people who are wearing the clothes and jubbas and imamas of Islam. And they are validating these positions and confusing our young Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have the power to lie. This is what we need to teach our children and our young persons. And also to move on, the person of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is also under attack. Do you know the same person who validated that position? He also made this claim. And this is somebody from within Islam. He also made this claim.
that if you insult Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, if you swear at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, if you say something to insult the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that person who insults the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will be considered a Muslim if he didn't intend to insult the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he tried to use Imam As-Subki rahmatullahi alayh. But alhamdulillah, Imam As-Subki rahmatullahi alayh, he mentions in his books that from the time of the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in until now, the entire Muslim Ummah has ijma, consensus, and is on one single unanimous view that whoever makes istighfaf and istihza of Rasulullah, whoever insults Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is out of the fold of Islam. This is not a debate of India and Pakistan anymore. Unfortunately, this has now transferred into English, and this debate is being presented on the internet and in the English language, and our young people are having to believe in this kind of stuff. To move on, we are living in a time when the Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in are under attack. And this time reminds me of that hadith narrated by Imam Tirmidhi rahmatullahi alayh in his Al-Jami'. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in Kitab al-Fitan, يُصْبِحُ الرَّجْلُ مُؤْمِنًا وَيُمْسِي الْكَافِرًا وَيُصْبِحُ كَافِرًا وَيُمْسِي مُؤْمِنًا. The time of their judgment, the time of Qiyamah, one of the signs of the corruptions of the day of the Qiyamah is that people will wake up as Muslims and go to sleep as non-Muslims. And people will wake up as non-Muslims and go to sleep as Muslims. I.e. the aqidah of people will be different in the morning and will be different in the night. The aqidah of people will be different in the morning and will be different at night. يُصْبِحُ الرَّجُلُ مُؤْمِنًا وَيُمْسِي كَافِرًا وَيُصْبِحُ الرَّجُلُ كَافِرًا وَيُمْسِي مُؤْمِنًا. And unfortunately, it seems like we are living in that day and age. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, إِذَا ظَهَرَتِ الْبِدَعُ وَالْفِتَنُ وَالصَّبُّ أَصْحَابِي فَلْيُظْهِرِ الْعَالِمُ عِلْمَهُ. When the time comes, when people attack Islam, when time comes, when heresy becomes prevalent, when time comes, when people leave the fold of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, when time comes, when my companions are being insulted, then everyone who has knowledge must speak out with his ilm and his knowledge. Isn't that the day we are living in? That is the day that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was speaking about. And alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, we have ulama who are fulfilling this duty, and among them is Qibla Shah Sahib. You see him defending the honor of Sahaba Kiram ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whichever alim does not defend my Sahaba when my Sahaba are being insulted, then the curse and wrath and la'nat of Allah be upon that alim. These Sahaba, these companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we have gathered to remember them. Significantly, the four of them, Hazrat Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Hazrat Umar Farooq, Hazrat Usman Ghani, Hazrat Ali Haydari Qarrar. All of the Sahaba Ikiram, they have been mentioned in the Quran with great qualities and virtues. If we pick up the Quran, Surah Ali Imran, verse number 110, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. Say Subhanallah.
Subhanallah.
You are the best ummah among all ummahs. You have been sent to humankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost is referring to the jamaat of sahaba ikiram. Is referring to the group around Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah is bearing witness that the Sahaba Kiram are the best of all ummas after our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They are the best.
Subhanallah.
If the Quran is giving testimony to the khairiyya, to the greatness of the Sahaba, who can question the integrity and the greatness of the Sahaba? in Surah Baqarah, verse 143, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. And likewise, we made you an ummah, a community of moderation. The Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'een have been given the quality of moderation. This means none of the Sahaba was extreme. None of the Sahaba were extreme. None of the Sahaba were extreme or strict. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving testimony of their moderation. Ummatan wasata. They are on the middle way, each and every one of them. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was not strict and extreme. Hazrat Umar Farooq was not strict and extreme. Hazrat Usman Ghani, Hazrat Ali Hadri Karrar, none of them. If somebody today brings riwayat and narrations about Hazrat Umar, that he was extreme with the Ahlul Bayt or with the family of the Prophet, all of these are rejected, because the verse of the Quran is giving testimony that none of the Sahaba are extreme. Ummatan wasata. In Surah Al-Tahrim, verse number 8, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ لَا يُخْزِ اللَّهُ النَّبِيَّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ نُورُهُمْ يَسْعَى بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ. Say Subhanallah. On the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never disappoint the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he will go to Jannah. And all of the Sahaba who accepted Iman with him will also go to Jannah. نورهم يسعى بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم. If you want to recognize the Sahaba, the Jamaat of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the Day of Judgment, you will see around Rasulullah and around the Sahaba there will be noor around them when they walk. Who is giving this testimony? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Tahrim, verse number 8. Now what do you think about those people who say that the Sahaba died in kufr, died in the state of disbelief, when Allah is saying يَوْمَ لَا يُخْزِ اللَّهُ النَّبِيَّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. Those people who believed in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah will never disappoint them on the Day of Judgment. They will go to Jannah. When Allah is giving the testimony that the Sahaba Ridwan will go to Jannah, then such reports have no value in Islam, and such riwayat and such information is baseless and useless, because the Quran is the first principle that we turn to. If we pick up Surah Al-Fatih, verse number 19, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the companions who gave pledge to Rasulullah under the tree. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ يُبَايُعُونَكَ تَحْتَ الشَّجَرَةِ. Their narration is, there were around 1400 sahaba kiram that gave bayah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam under the tree. And the Quran is saying Allah is pleased with all of those sahaba ikiram. Now this is a rule. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with someone, that person will never die in the state of kufr. If Allah is pleased with someone, he will never die in the state of. Now those people who believe that only a few sahaba, they remained as Muslims and all of the rest became kuffar after Rasulullah passed away, they are contradicting this verse of Al-Quran Al-Karim. Are they? لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ يُبَايُعُونَكَ تَحْتَ الشَّجَرَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, indeed Allah has become pleased with the Sahaba, those believers who gave bay'ah to, pledge to Rasulullah under the tree. And there were about 1400 of them. If we pick up Surah Al-Tawbah, verse 100, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Al-Fatih, verse 29, we are repeatedly reminded, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. Say Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving testimony to the greatness of the Sahaba ikiram. He says, and those people who accepted Islam in the early days, from the Muhajireen and then from the Ansar, the people who lived in Makkah, and those who accepted Islam in Medina, وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ, and those who came after them and followed in their way, in following goodness, رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. Allah is pleased with all of those sahaba kiram, and they are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Fatih, verse 29, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مُحَمَّدٌ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا سيماهم في وجوههم من أثر السجود.
These are verses of Al-Quran Al-Kareem giving testimony of the greatness of all of the Sahaba Ikram Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we do not take any riwaya, any narration which goes against these verses of Al-Quran Al-Kareem, because Quran Al-Kareem is the fundamental principle that we follow. Anything that is in contradiction with Al-Quran Al-Kareem, anything that is in contradiction with the tazkiyah of the Sahaba, the adala of the Sahaba, the integrity of the Sahaba, the fazail of the Sahaba, the merits of the Sahaba, the virtues of Rasulullah's companions, we do not accept it. Because the Quran is talking about their virtues. The Quran is endorsing the integrity of the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in. And Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. Everybody say radiyallahu anhu. He has been mentioned and referred to in Al-Quran al-Kareem in a number of verses. In one verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِي جَاءَ بِالصِّدْقِ وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ. Say subhanallah. And the one who brought the truth, i.e. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the one who gave testimony to his truth, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ. In another verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثَانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. When two of them, when the second of the two of them, i.e. the Prophet and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, when they were in the cave, and when one of them, i.e. the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said to his companion, لصاحبه, to his companion Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, لا تحزن, don't have grief, إن الله معنا, indeed Allah is with us. You have heard from Hazrat Shah Sahib and many of the ulama, Hazrat Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu is the only sahabi whose sahabiyyat, whose companionship has been mentioned by wording in the Quran. لِصَاحِبِهِ. The companion of Rasulullah, this word has been singled out for Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq in Al-Quran Al-Kareem. So the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majmain, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, Hazrat Umar Farooq, all of the Sahaba have the great maqams in their own sense. I must clarify one thing here. When we say haq jariya for friends of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are not denying the existence of the other Sahaba. This is a very important point. When we say haq jariyar, when we single out the four, we are not denying the fazilat of the remaining of the Sahaba. We are not denying the existence or the virtue or the merits of the other Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Why? Let me explain to you. If I say la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. If I say this, Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, does this mean that I am denying the messengerhood of Hazrat Ibrahim? If I say Muhammad Rasulullah, Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, I'm singling out Rasulullah with the wasf of Risala, with the attribute of Risala, am I denying the existence of the other messengers? Am I denying the virtue of the other messengers? So when I say Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I am not denying the risalat of Hazrat Adam. I am not denying the risalat of Hazrat Musa. I am not denying the risalat of Hazrat Zakariya. I am not denying the risalat of Hazrat Isa. I am not denying the risalat of any of the other Rusul and Anbiya. So why is it that when we say haq jariya, you think we are denying the fazilat of the other Sahaba? We are not denying the existence of the fazilat of the other Sahaba Ikiram. The reason why we speak about these four is because these were the best four after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And people say the ijma, the consensus that Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was the best one after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this ijma is zanni. You can have different views on this. He doesn't have to be the best. Imam Bayhaqi in Kitab al-I'tiqad, Hazrat Maulana, Nare Takbir, Nare Risalat, Ulama-e Ahle Sunnat, Imam Bayhaqi in Kitab al-I'tiqad, he narrates from Hazrat Imam Shafi'i, everybody say Rahmatullahi Alayh. He said, مَخْتَلَفَ أَحَدٌ مِنَ السَّحَابَةِ أَوِ التَّابِعِينَ فِي تَفْضِيلِ أَبِي بَكْرٍ وَعُمَرَ وَتَقْدِيمِهِمَا عَلَى جَمِيعِ السَّحَابَةِ. Hazrat Imam Shafi'i Rahmatullahi Alayh, narrated by Imam Bayhaqi in Kitab al-I'tiqad with a full sahih sanad, he says Hazrat Imam Shafi was from the Taba'i Tabi'in. He says none of the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in and none of the Tabi'in had the view that any one of the Sahaba is better than Abu Bakr and Umar. all of them agreed that Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq and Hazrat Umar Farooq are the best of all Sahaba Ikram. And if you pick up Allama Lalkai Sharhu Usul I'tiqad Ahl Sunnah, Allahu Akbar, probably one of the biggest resources, the biggest books I have seen, where he has given the opinions of the ulama of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah from the Salaf, who say there is ijma on the view that Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq and Umar Farooq are best of all Sahaba Ikram. And Alhamdulillah, I have written a small book, Afzaliyat Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, or Maslake Ala Hazrat. And in this book, I have tirelessly researched through about 40 books of Imam Ahmad Ridha Khan. What does he say about the greatness of Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu? Ala Hazrat Fazil Bareilvi rahmatullah alayh, in more than 30 books he says that Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq is the best of the Sahaba. Whoever denies this is out of the fold of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Whoever denies that Abu Bakr Siddiq is the best of the Sahaba is out of the fold of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Because the agreement on the greatness of Abu Bakr over all the Sahaba, this agreement is decisive. The ijma is not zanni, the ijma is qat'i. And I have shown this in this book. Imam Ahmad Raza Khan clearly says the ijma on the greatness of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq is qat'i, not zanni. And this is the way of Imam Ahmad Raza Khan. Inshallah, this will be available to you. And once they arrive from Pakistan, I will make them available here in Bradford. My dear brothers and elders, our ulama are living today. Sadly, when our ulama die, then we remember them. You know, when our buzurg passed away, then we make a urs and we say, "Bahut bade alim the, bade kaam kiye." But when they are alive, we forget about them. We only remember them after their demise. Why is this happening? Alhamdulillah, you beautiful faces are a great witness, are a great testimony that you are with the ulama of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah whilst they are alive. Be like the Sahaba Ikram. These are the Wurafa, the heirs of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Become like the companions. Be with them, help them, support them. Who wants to help the ulama of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah? Hands up. Inshallah, we want to help the ulama of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. We want to help the ulama of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah defend the honor of Allah. We want the ulama of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah to defend the honor of Rasulullah. We want the ulama of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah to defend the honor of the Sahaba Ikram. We want the ulama of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah to defend the honor of Ahl Bayt Ikram. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي قائمين وفي رواية ظاهرين على الحق لا يخافون لومة لائم. There will always be a group of ulama in my ummah till the end and the time of judgment who will always speak the truth. They will always fight against falsehood. They will always speak the truth and they will not fear anyone. Don't we see that in Shah Sahib? Don't we see that? He is fearless. He is courageous. Come, we are ready, Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. We are ready because we are ready to give our lives for the honor of Allah and Rasulullah and the Sahaba Ikram. Inshallah, we are all ready. And Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah will always survive till the end of time because this is the guarantee of Rasulullah. La tazalu ta'ifatun min ummati. There will always be a group among my ulama in my ummah who will always defend the truth. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah.
سامعین اعزام، میں